As the weather eventually warms up, many of you will head outside for a jog, and you might be prepared with your water bottle and running shoes. But are you prepared if someone were to come up to you from behind? This is something I think about all the time when I am out running. So I'm so excited to have Jody Token with us this morning. She is a coach and the founder of thegreatflip.com. Good morning to
you. Good morning.
Jody, I think this is fantastic that we're talking about this because you are going to give me a few self-defense moves.
Yes.
And for all of our viewers.
Yes.
So first off, let's talk about simply when someone comes up and invades our personal space.
Right. So before there's even a physical interaction, there's things that we can do to be more self-aware about our space and distance management with someone. And if someone's coming in for that really uncomfortable hug,
yes,
or even coming into you and you don't want them, mm-hmm, a simple thing you can do is, even to be kind about it and assertive about it, is to take one step back, mm-hmm, and then extend your hand.
That makes
sense.
Like,
hey, instead of the big hug, it's like, hi, it's nice to meet you.
Okay, good.
And then you've created a space, mm-hmm, and you've just established your boundaries.
All of us are
in
not
a very kind
huggers.
Way.
I'm not a hugger, so I'm gonna be using that one. Let's talk about when we are out running. Obviously, we can't see what's going on behind us. Can we do a demonstration on someone potentially grabbing us?
Sure.
Okay, and we're having Matt play the role of the bad guy
yep,
for this one. So Jody,
you can call me Billie Eilish because I'm the bad guy.
Oh boy.
Yep.
Jody, you can walk us through this scenario.
Sure. So if he comes from behind, mm-hmm, and grabs, if he grabs over your arms, a little bit more scary,
mm-hmm,
and or if he goes even around your neck, that's even more scary. Mm-hmm. So if he does that, first of all, he might be in a position to choke you. Mm-hmm. So the first thing you want to do is make sure the choke is not going to hurt you.
Okay.
So you actually want to grab his wrist and his forearm on the arm that's about to choke you.
Okay.
And you may not be able to pull it away, but you, mm-hmm, can at least pull it down.
Okay.
To get that choke off. Mm-hmm. And then I teach like little kids and even taller people, and if they're, you know, behind you, mm-hmm, you can actually just drop down.
Okay.
And don't be afraid to even drop all the way down to the ground just to get away from, mm-hmm, them. Now there's some really cool like flips and takedowns.
Let's do it. No, I'm kidding.
I won't allow her to do that. She certainly could take you down.
She would be more than capable. I know it, yeah.
But really, you want to get that choke off. Mm-hmm. I tell the girls to kind of like make a big muscle and then just kind of do a nice big giant hard squat down and get away from them.
Okay.
And it usually disrupts just what they're doing to you anyway.
It's not what they're going to expect,
no,
I'm sure.
So they're thinking that you might try to pull away. Well, you can't pull away. You're smaller. You're not going to be able to take all that strength,
yeah,
but you,
right,
can. You can protect yourself from, mm-hmm, that choke and then drop away from that.
Something I am afraid about is having my arm grabbed, yeah, and trying to be pulled into a car.
Yes. Now, this is even a life skill. You know, girls, mm-hmm, can be hanging out at the mall and they're like, oh, I'm going to, yeah, pull you over here to come see something that's on sale,
mm-hmm,
or a very violent situation. So a lot of the things I teach not only are self-defense, but they're life skills for, mm-hmm, girls to know. So if somebody grabs you,
yeah,
first of all, you don't want to be like facing them right away, or you, mm-hmm, want to see what your base is like, because if he pulls you, you're going to immediately go towards him, right?
Mm-hmm.
You want to make sure you're actually standing nice and strong to the side,
okay,
where all your strength can be in your legs. I know you have your heels on, but, mm-hmm, sometimes you might have
I'll
heels
kick
on.
Them off. That's right.
And you're going to, when he pulls, you're going to kind of almost like put all your strength in your back leg a little, mm-hmm, bit so that he can't pull you anymore.
Okay.
And when you're ready to escape, you can take actually one small step towards him. It already took a little pressure off of,
yeah,
his elbow right there.
Yeah.
Now I want you to take your elbow down like you're taking a big scoop of ice cream,
mm-hmm,
and then scoop it up and out.
Okay.
And now your elbow is also there to be an extra
and maybe hit him
assertive
in the face
or aggressive move.
Mm-hmm.
But all I'm teaching children to do and young ladies to do is to escape,
mm-hmm,
and reestablish their boundaries again. Maybe hands up,
mm-hmm,
not closed, because that looks like you want to aggravate, mm-hmm, the situation. Hands,
right,
open to calm the person down. Use your voice. Your voice, mm-hmm, is your first line of self-defense.
Yeah.
And calm down. Reestablish your boundaries.
This is such an important conversation to have for women out there, for parents out there. So please join us for GDXL. Jody's going to stick around. We'll be right here in the Bomarito Digital Studio starting around 10:15, where Kent, we are going to go through many more moves.
Cool.
I think
That'd
this is so important.
It is.
Yeah, good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
All right. That's coming up right after the show, about 10:15.
Mm-hmm.